Right, when it comes to factoring, there are many ways you can factor, but there's only one right answer. You could use trial error, you could use box methods. I give you all sorts of methods for doing this. The first one is the difference of two squares. So what times itself is 16x squared? 4x goes in the first part of each parenthesis. One's a plus and one's a minus. And then what squared is 25? 5. So we have 4x plus 5 times 4x minus 5. Remember, the order does not matter. You could put 4x minus 5, that factor, first. Okay, this one I'm going to do by grouping. I'm going to, out of the first two, I'm going to factor out an x. And out of the second two, I'm going to factor out a 4a. So now I have a common factor of x minus 3. That's the answer. X minus 3 times x plus 4a. And the way to check both of these problems so far is you do the FOIL method and you get the same four terms. Okay, for this last one, this one's the more simple one to factor because it can only be an x and an x. And now you want factors of 24 that when you subtract them you get 5, and that's going to be 8 and 3. So you could do some trial error to get that. You have to make sure the plus is in front of the 8 and the minus is in front of the 3. You can't switch it. You could put x minus 3 times x plus 8. That's all right. Okay, this one's slightly more complicated, but again, you can use trial factors or any of the methods that you learned how to factor. All right. So let's see, with trial error, I'm going to do it that way. I know this has to be a 5x and an x, because those are the only ways, that's the only way to ever get a 5x squared. And then you have to come up with the right combination, and it happens to be minus 6 and plus 3. But you could try working this out by using any of the methods where you do the product and sum, etc. Okay, let's look at E. Now, for this one, this looks like it could be a perfect square because that's a perfect square, 36x squared, and so is 49. So I'm going to hope it's a perfect square, but I'm not sure. Since the middle term's minus, there's going to be a minus here. So I think what times itself is 36x squared? 6x. And what times itself is 49? But I must check the middle term. Check the middle term. Remember, it's 2 times 6x times the negative 7, which is negative 48x, just like it should be. So, all right, that's the right answer. If not, if you don't get the right middle term, then you need to try some other method. All right, 9x to the 4th minus 25. Well, this is the difference of two squares again. So what times itself is 9x to the 4th? 3x squared. And what times itself is 25? 5. So one's a plus and one's a minus 5. Okay, G. There's a common factor here, and that's always the first step in factoring. So the greatest common factor in these three terms is 2x squared. And then that leaves me x squared plus 14x plus 49. That looks like a perfect square. Again, just like the previous, well, a couple problems above. So 2x squared is still out here, and then you need to factor this, and actually it's going to be plus 7 and plus 7, x plus 7 times x plus 7. So you could either leave your answer like this, or you can write it as 2x squared times the quantity x plus 7 squared. Both of those are correct. Let's look at H. Well, again, I have a common factor of 3x this time. So that's going to be 8x squared plus x minus 9. And then we need to factor that. And again, there's lots of different methods you could use for factoring it. Going to do trial factors here. I'm going to try 8x and x. Try to get a middle term. So it looks like 9 and 1. It's going to be here. And I need a plus 9 and a minus. So that's going to be your answer here. Because that gives you the right outer and inner term, the 9x minus 8x. If you need help on factoring, go to my factoring videos, pick a method and stick with it. Right, use factoring to solve each equation and then check. So, what we need to do here is first make sure it's equal to 0, which it is, and then factor. So, there's got to be a 2x. And again, you could do this on scratch paper, figure out how to factor this. It's going to be a 4 and a 1. It'll be a minus and a plus will give me the right middle term. All right, so the first thing is to factor the left-hand side and then set each factor equal to 0. So either 2x plus 1 is equal to 0 or x minus 4 is 0. So 2x is negative 1. You divide by 2, that gives you x is negative 1/2, and x equals 4. So it looks like those are the solutions, and you should definitely check both of those in the original. I'm going to check the 4. Well, let's check the negative 1/2. You check negative 1/2 into 2x squared minus 7x minus 4 equals 0 by plugging in negative 1/2 for x. So you have 2 times, well, x squared is 1/2 times 1/2, minus 7 times 1/2. I'm sorry, I'm plugging in negative 1/2. Negative 1/2, negative 1/2. There we are. Okay, so the 2's cancel here. This will be a positive 1/2, and that'll be plus 7/2 minus 4. And that's 8/2, right? 1/2 plus 7/2 is 8/2. That's 4 minus 4, which is 0. So you can see that when I plugged in negative 1/2, that's the harder one to check. And I'll leave that to you to plug in 4. Instead of plugging in negative 1/2, you'll put in 4 for x and make sure the left side equals 0. Okay. 3x squared equals 5x. Well, it's not equal to 0. So first you're going to have to subtract 5x. So it equals 0, and then factor. Oops, you can't factor out a 3. You can factor out an x. So either the x equals 0 or 3x minus 5 equals 0. So 0 looks like it's one solution. And add 5 to both sides. And it looks like 5/3 is the other solution. And then you would have to check by plugging in 5/3. I don't have room to do it right here, but you should be able to get out scratch paper, put in 5/3 for x, and simplify all this, and make sure you really do get a 0. 0 is easy to check. If you put in 0, you get 3 times 0 is 0. Actually, 3 times 0 squared is still 0, and then minus 5 times 0. So you have 0 minus 0 is 0. So 0 is the easy one to try. X equals 5/3, a few more steps there. Okay. So, I've got, again, not equal to 0. So what you want to do is set the equation equal to 0 and then factor it. So either the first factor is 0 or the second factor is 0. That's how we get two different solutions. 5 or negative 3. Okay, now let's check these. Let's check 5. 5 squared minus t times 5, does that equal 15? That's the big question. Yep, 25 minus 10 is 15. Good. Now let's put in negative 3 for x. So negative 3 squared minus t times negative 3, does that equal 15? Well, that's 9 plus 6 is 15. Yep. So I did have room to check those.